On a controversy as big as the recent tussle between the Iglesia ni Cristo and the government, many politicians were notably silent, even those who always make their voices heard on just about every issue. Those who spoke did so in support of the group, including Vice President Jejomar Binay, the opposition's candidate for president, and Senator Grace Poe, who is said to be preparing to run for a higher position in 2016.
Respetuhin natin no, yung pagpoprotesta nila. They have to protect their faith. At saka sinisira yung religious institution.
Huwag din natin mamaliitin ang importansya rin ng reliyon, di ba? Para sa akin, ang mga tao na yan, ang dinidepensahan nila ay ang kanilang paniniwala. Nirerespeto natin yan at kailangan ay pangalagaan din ang kanilang mga karapatan.
Senator Francis Escudero said Justice Secretary Leila De Lima should prioritize her department's investigation on the Mamasapano incident and let the INC resolve what he believes appears to be a purely internal matter. Senator Ferdinand Marcos Jr. meanwhile criticized the Justice Department's handling of the illegal detention case against some INC officials, saying it created the impression the agency had undue interest in the case. He said the INC has the right to stage a peaceful mass action to express their sentiments in defense of their faith. Both Escudero and Marcos are possible candidates for higher posts in 2016. Politicians who defended the INC drew flak on social media, where netizens ranted against the traffic standstill the demonstration caused. Even the feisty Davao City Mayor Rodrigo Duterte defended the INC's protest.
The Constitution, which is the highest law of the land, guarantees under the Bill of Rights for citizens to peaceably assemble for a redress of grievance. I have not seen any unruly or a behavior that would warrant police action.
Secretary Mar Rojas, the administration's presidential bet, said while all citizens have the right to be heard and to peaceful assembly, protest actions cannot impinge on the rights of others or cause inconvenience, especially to people going home to rest and be with their families. Senator Aquilino Pimentel III said government has many lessons to learn from the INC's protest and the inconvenience it caused on motorists and commuters.
Let us all learn from this incident some lessons. They have to review their ordinances pagdating sa grant ng mga permit. And then number two, the enforcement of the conditions of the permit. Dapat nga you're allowed to rally, but not to block a main artery for transportation. And then police and then the LGU must review their protocols. Kung sakaling gawin yan, ano naman ang dapat nilang gawin? Ano naman ang reaction? Is it to arrest?
Pimentel, a lawyer, also said the principle of the separation of church and state cannot be invoked in INC's case because it involves a criminal complaint against some of its leaders. He urged the public to monitor the case's progress because it reports government struck a deal with a powerful church to end the demonstrations. Ryan Chua, ABS-CBN News.